Kick me one of them funky ass beats.
Let's explain how it all fits together. We assume that all these people at the beginning in episode 1 at the fort arrived on the Daffodil. The Daffodil is basically the sister ship of the famous Mayflower. We assume that the age, the anno, the year is basically 1701. And based on the age of the people then, we can work out an artificial birth date. And they were born in foreign parts, they were not born at the location. Then as we get some housing, we see who hooks up with whom, and at that point we can assign their family names. For example, Damonti hooks up with Anna Marissa, female, and they already had a child, so they arrived as a couple. So therefore we can give them names and work out from there. And then it's just a matter of waiting on the firstborn. The firstborn will be the name giver, in this case Winifred Cooper. Winnie Cooper is basically the daughter of Evante Cooper and Gracely Jones. Evante Cooper was born in December 1696 in foreign parts. Gracely Jones was born in August 1697 in foreign parts. Winifred Cooper is born at the new colony, but Winnie already had an older sister, Cassandy, which was born in 1699 in foreign parts. It will be explained further on as we progress. So, that being said, believe me, it will become more clear as we progress, believe me. We ended last episode with the overview of the family names we had, the couples we had, and the firstborn Winnie Cooper, and the secondborn is actually Milburn Lius. Who comes up with these names? Cooper, Winnie's little brother. So, without further ado, let's go on with the third episode. So, there we go. Still Winter Wonderland. Where is everybody? Why is nobody moving? Either way, let's have a look. The Mini Forester, let's get that one started. Let the Mini Gatherer start. Where is everybody? Oh. Yeah, of course. Shoot. Press start. Move. Now, let's see. Ah, Winnie has grown all up. Well. And Mundo and Loris are living here. Evante, Winnie and her little brother. Okay. De Monti, Tadden, Sandri, Rainy, Brenton, Wol, Gail, Mara. Okay. Looks like the building is all going very nice. Let's see, what else shall we add in? Just another tiny shack. As I said before, I prefer working with these houses because I think it makes it easier to control the population growth, but mileage might vary, of course, but okay, this forester, just okay, start planting stuff. The gatherer, mini gatherer, go on, start gathering stuff. What else do we got here? Another forester. Yeah, continue building this forester. Okay. Add a little bit of growth now, maybe. Shall we add another stockpile over there somewhere? Dedicated wood stockpile. Oh, looks like that's a little bit too enthusiastic. Let's put in the stockpile between the forester and the housing over there. Little 30 double row wood stockpile, which makes it, which brings the logs a bit closer to the woodcutter, and we'll probably be adding a woodcutter at this corner at some point anyway. But let's reduce speed a little bit because we've got another child. Where? Chela Mara. Ah, oh, there it is. Edmundo and Loris have a son, Kelvis, who apparently did not leave the building. Okay, lame jokes aside. Yeah, I know. How are we doing here? Why is this forester not working? Yeah, we're a little bit low on labor force, of course, which is... It's an issue. I could put in extra housing to kind of make the population explode, but there's a price to pay for population explosions, so... let's try avoid doing that. So, what else? Well, at least we've got already some... Mini forester is ready. Start planting stuff. We do need to employ more foresters though. Shall we put in another forest house? There maybe... don't know if that's the best location, but... yeah, come on, let's go. What else do we have got? Farmhouses? Boston houses? Farmhouses? Looks nice. Of course we're gonna put in the farmhouses as soon as we build farms. Not yet at this point, so... What else do we've got? A bit low with, like, only two builders, only one laborer. We could use with a lot more people, but yeah. So whenever they've got the time, the builders, let's build that house next there, so that as soon as the house is in, we can put in the extra barn, and then we can put in the fishing dock. Just a matter of making sure that our food supplies remain adequate. At this point, with 4,000 food, we're more or less okay, but it can change quickly, so... Shall we continue with the blacksmith and everything? That might be a good mining place. Not for the big iron and coal mines, maybe, but for like the small mines, the not the diamonds, but the opals, the mining, the diamonds, the sapphires, whatever, the little the little valuables mining thing. Now, Minifer seems to be living alone. Maybe I should have kind of... Maybe I should have created a Fred Savage. But at the time I didn't think about naming a family Savage, so... Well, it is what it is. I've got a few kids. Arjunal and... Fren. And Lilian and Rosanna Marie. Who comes up with these names? There we go. Well, the good thing is that soon we'll have some extra labor force. And by God, we can use them. Now, Banished is all about managing resources and population. Your most important resource is basically your population, so... Can't be fooling around with it. Now, our logs have become low, so we put in some cutting. I wish we hadn't have to do that yet. I would prefer to build up a solid forest first, but yeah. Thing is, we don't really have enough laborers to kind of start gathering resources, stone, logs, iron, in large places, large areas, large selections. So we'll have to do what we have to do. So we're gonna try to grab smaller sections, but yet enough and not too far away, of course, because if it's too far away, we're gonna run into troubles with like starvation and freezing and stuff like that. Winifer is still alone. Should try to find a mate for her as soon as possible. But... And by God, it does rain a lot in Banished. Let's see, shall we put in... Yeah. It's not a question of shall we put in... lodging, boarding house, it's more a matter of like, when shall we put it in? It's really one of these buildings, I think, is really needed. Especially at some point I start upgrading houses and these people have to go somewhere. If there are no houses, they become homeless, obviously. You get this whole problem of starvation and freezing and everything again. But not only that, at that point your population kind of stagnates for a moment. As soon as the house is upgraded, then it becomes free again and people move in. And most of the time since you upgrade your house, it's bigger. So it then boosts population growth. After the upgrade, but during the upgrade, people have to go somewhere, and that's where the boarding house comes in. I do love the medieval boarding house. It looks like a very nice building, but we're gonna stick with the classic one for now. And later on, as we build on up the town. We will use the medieval first floor and second floor and attic boarding houses, just like we will use the farming houses when we get to building farms. Hunters and Winnie is still alone. Rainy is living over there now. He's probably gonna become a fisherman or woman, fisher person, to be a bit political correct. Although I think in the 1700s political correctness was not as looming as it is today. Yeah, we're gonna pause this boarding house because it needs a lot of resources and we frankly do not have all these resources. And besides that, not only needs it a lot of resources, it takes a long time to build also. Might be more in our interest to kind of get some of the other buildings started. Shall I put in a big woodcutter already, or can it wait on a little bit? I'm not sure. I think we can still manage with a single, but yeah, let's put in the floor plan. At least then I can make it go on, start building it whenever necessary. Okay, that little barn is ready and the fishing dock is at 50%. Good. Where are my builders? Where are my laborers? Come on, people. See, we've already got one of the problems, like 3-4 hammer strokes and disappearing again. I hope that Rainy, who's living next door, would kinda build the fishing dock, but apparently not. There are maybe a little bit too many jobs queued because there's this whole resource gathering stuff still going on all these marked areas. And we've only got like 2 laborers and 2 builders, and they tend to divide their time between all these allocated jobs. Of course, it's easy to solve by basically prioritizing one of the jobs, but yeah, don't like to do that too many times. 2 builders, 2 laborers. Come on. What else? At some point we have to put in the trader. Not too soon, but when you're like around 20k, that's a good time. Basically, it all depends on how self-sufficient you are. If you've got enough food, if you've got enough resources, wood, firewood, stone, iron, you can wait a little bit before putting in the trader. Also because initially you don't have a lot of stuff to trade with. So you can start off with, that's a nice building. You can start off with the firewood economy. But for that you basically need a lot more foresters. And at this point, I do not have enough foresters yet. I do not have a big reserve of wood yet. And so it's a bit too soon for the trader. Not gonna wait too long though anymore. A little roof over the head of the wood chopper. Yeah, it's probably a good idea. How to orient like this? Will it work like this or? See, I don't know all these buildings which are available in the mega mod, so. We're discovering some of these together. You and me. Come on. Yeah, let's put it there. Yet another job for the builders, but it's a small thing. It should kind of go fast. What else do we have? Traders. Small traders. Livestock traders. General traders. Let's see. How do these things look like? Seed trader, small livestock trader, building materials trader, nice. Classic trading post, arm suppliers, food suppliers, tiny trader. Yeah, I'm just gonna put in the traditional trading post. Now bear with me because I'm a bit fussy on my trading post. I want kind of like the ideal and best looking position. So believe me, this is not just like slam it down somewhere. This is me just being very, very fussy. Bit OCD, a bit anal probably. I just want the ideal position as far inland as possible while still having this crane in the water and having the dock in the water but without kind of blocking the rivers. There we go. Footprint is in place. We're not gonna build it yet. Like I said, probably around 20 plus population, and I mean 20 plus adult population, so that we can fill in the jobs, because at this point we still cannot fill in the jobs. Now whatever, it looks like a nice mini trading post. Shall I put it there somewhere? After all, I've been using the mini forester over there also. The standard general big trading post. The position there is because this is where basically more or less the town center will be. While what we're doing here, have a little bit of growth. This is still a forester's node. I know. Lots of people to be a forester's node, but as I explained before, I work with multiple forester nodes and I work with kind of little hamlet kind of things within the forester node. So I put most of the time the foresters to plant trees, so we get like a very thick forest. And that kind of compensates for the area which has been taken up by the houses and stuff. So it's not just at random. Now this is how I do it. Other players might go, but you know, this is completely stupid. You should not do it. You should be. Yes, probably. It's all about a bit min-maxing also, and I do not always go for min-maxing, although I do have the tendency to go a bit compact and optimization, like efficiency, without going necessarily for min-maxing. Start off in the beginning with as much efficiency as possible to get going. Once it's rolling along, then of course I tend to kind of go for how it looks, how it still works together but still looks fine. And yes, and I always have to fight the tendency to work very compact, and that's probably something we're gonna find out somewhere in the future when we've got like a fire. Then we find out that I have a tendency to build my houses much too close together. We're a bit low on tools and clothing. Yeah. Another child. And Milburn has become an adult and he moved in with Rainy, that's good. That's good. Winnie is still alone though. How's my workshop going on? I did dedicate my workshop to start building tools, yes? So this is where Yvette is. Cosmo is there. Malone is there. Anjanel is there. Fran is there. Lillian is there. It's all very, very nice. Yvette is a child. Looks at this barn is kind of filling up a little bit. It's not that we've got an overabundance of goods. But yeah, it is a small barn, so all the other stuff is stored in the old castle, the old fort, and some of the stuff is stored in those little cellars. See, this area is still marked for resource gathering. And they haven't gotten to it yet. Finally they're on their way. Two laborers and two builders acting as laborers. So extend the road a little bit, like I said. Somewhere in the future this will become a marketplace. This big stockpile will disappear and I'll put a market in there, but for now let's see what other buildings can we put around here. See, we have the well, worthless well, nomad wells, village well, yeah, gazebo, town arrival, mini town hall, town arrival. I don't know if the version which attract nomads at some point. Mini town hall, mini standard town hall, meeting house. Nice building. Homecoming. It's a statue. The White House. Yeah. Probably works with the times, but still. Colonial Hall. Courthouse. Governor's Office. Yeah. Small Town Hall. Looks like a nice building. Migration Office. Interesting. Maybe we should apply that one somewhere at some point. castle. Yes, but let's stick to the standard town hall, shall we? We're still close enough to the water. We don't need a well yet, so standard town hall. What would be a nice position? Yeah, I think that one, that over there somewhere. Yeah, a little bit. I'm a bit fussy on the town hall also. Like, that's because once I put down a town hall, I'm not gonna break it down for whatever reason. So I tend to kind of try to imagine how it will look like in the future. So I wanted to kind of work out when I extend the roads, when I go for the footpaths and the different kind of roads and little garden around it, some pottery, some statues. That's when the this is basically being ready for the beautification of the town later on. Well, and it's about time to think about a school. Yeah, I will I will probably be putting a school for the town already, but probably only the footprint. However, in the little forest hamlet, we can do it with one of these tiny schools, or basically this outdoor well teaching place. This mini school. Yeah, I think it would work well over there, so let's go with that. How are we doing with the hunters? Kelvis has grown up, so it's labor. Got a new child, Sana, where is she? Yeah. Kelvis and Winifer, when are you going to kind of provide offspring? Your little brother and Rainy have created offspring already. You know, this would not look good, eh, Winnie? You're naming the town, you're basically the most important person of the town. You're kind of like responsible for the offspring of the Cooper family, as being the most influential people in the town, you know? You are, well, after all, the name giver of the town, Winnie Cooper. It wouldn't go down very well if there would be no offspring. Nice, nice, nice cathedral. Shall we put it in? Cathedral, okay, it's not a cathedral, it's one of these, I would say, typical English churches, but you know. Or shall we put in the more traditional chapels? The mini chapel, that's an idea, but at some point we're gonna need a little bit more than that. Central church is a bit too big, too overdone. I love this one, it's a very nice building. Smallish, yeah, it's an option. And it's just a small chapel. Town chapel. Yes, it's great. Parish house. Little chapel. I don't know what we're gonna put in. Yeah. if we put in that little chapel, we're gonna put it over there somewhere together. Maybe even side by side with the little schooling area over there. Just, you know, it's a bit expanding on the forest hamlet, but yeah. We still got enough laborers, so yeah, we can put in the religious place. Wenderson, where are you, Wenderson? Yay! Kelvis and Winifer have a child. Good. Fishing dock, two people for the fishing dock, please. Town hall, oh yeah. We need lumber for that. Which means that we have to put in like a lumber mill or a workshop that can create lumber. Or one of these specialized foresters that need lumber. That produce lumber, so let's wait for it for a while. See if we can gather some other stuff. It's not crucial yet, the town hall. It helps a lot in giving you an overview on what's going on, but at this point it's all still a bit manageable, so can do without the town hall. But what we can do is kind of assigning more foresters now that we've got a slightly larger labor force. We still need one more, I think. Now if one shorter, it's not an issue. One of the foresters will kind of commute between the two locations, but where are my gatherers? Okay, they're not too far off. Looks okay. Now we've got a lot of tools at this point. Maybe it's time to switch back to making coats. Making clothing again. What's the next one we're gonna continue building? In the cellar, Annemarie, Yvette. Yeah, we're nearing the end of this episode, so I'm rounding off, so to speak. I'm having a look on what's going on. Who is living where, and come on, have these foresters plant a lot of trees. How's the fishing going, actually? Either way, we're there. I'll give an overview after this, and then basically, if you like it, like it. If you don't like it, don't like it. If you want to, please subscribe. If you have comments, suggestions, whatever, put it all down at the bottom in the comment section. And besides that, keep on rocking.